If someone's taking LDN for something besides MCAS, can it inadvertently increase mast cell activation? I'm sorry. I don't see how myself. Okay. It can inadvertently cause other things to happen. I can give you a color story. Very often people will take methylated vitamins, okay, and have one of four reactions. One, they take a methylated vitamin and they really don't feel comfortable. Okay. They start getting really shaky and stuff like that, to which I usually say, stop. Okay. Because they'll come over to me and say, I can only have a crumb of methyl B12. I'm like, why are you taking it? Because I need the methyl B12. So, you know, not getting enough B12 there. Okay. So if they start taking it and a week or two goes by and then they start feeling worse, what's going on there is that you're pushing other pathways. Okay. You've built it up a bit, but it's now affecting other pathways. The third scenario is that you start taking it, you feel better. You hit the nail on the head. Fourth scenario, you're taking the methyl B12, and I'm just using methylated B12 at the moment, methylated B12, and you don't feel better, you don't feel worse. Well, that just means that your body is accepting the methyl B12, but it's not the answer to any kind of problem. Okay. So if there's more mast cell activation, it might be something different that's setting it off. The LDN works with the toll-like receptors. There's a whole lot more receptors and a whole lot more things to think about. Okay, when you're talking about, if you want to call it mast cell activation, okay? So those are things I would consider.